I had to actually go to her because she couldn't be bothered to come to me. Her mother is Debbie Reynolds. Her father is Eddie Fisher. Her stepmother is Elizabeth Taylor. So that's who she is. She started off her life as Princess Leia. Then she dropped the princess and picked up the pen, and she lived there ever since. She is, among everything else, a leading expert on relationships. Now we will go to Carrie Fisher. Okay, what's the time now?
The time now is 2:15.
2:15. And we were here since?
Well, I've been here since 10:15.
10:15, waiting for Carrie Fisher. A lot of you may wonder, who is Carrie Fisher? As are we all. But whoever she is, she's made us wait here for 4 hours. It's a peeved look. All I can say is, she better be funny while she's out. They say she's off drugs, and we can only hope. Fingers crossed. Anything could come through that door. Well, let's show the books, and maybe that's as good as having her on the show. Here, you pretend you're Carrie Fisher, and I'll pretend I'm Carrie Fisher's friend. Hi, Carrie.
Hello.
I really like your book.
Thank you.
Did it take long to write?
No.
That's been very interesting. Thanks for being on the show.
Thank you.
Look, pretend I'm Carrie Fisher. Pretend I'm Carrie Fisher. Come on, ask me some questions.
Are you off the drugs now?
Off the drugs, completely off the drugs. Once in a while, I wake up and I'm not sure if I'm in the right room, but otherwise, I'm perfectly fine. Is she coming? Recognize her?
It isn't my first B12 shot. It is, as a mother, which you would think it would be a better, hello, I'm Princess Leia Organa. Fly me to Alderaan.
Do you know who she is? Be honest.
No.
No. What do you think she does for a living?
Thank you.
Food fight! What does she do, do you think? And why are we filming
her? Why are people talking to me? She's a high fashion model.
Wait. High fashion model.
It used to be, but she had a horrible accident.
Horrible.
But you were an actress, and that was further than I got. I don't know
you
how good
be?
Or bad.
I'm desperate.
We discussed
yeah,
well,
try
this yesterday.
Saying Governor Tarkin.
You
I
got
thought
into
I
Central School of Drama.
Stench. Yeah.
Do you want to say why or you don't want to mention it? It was an endurance. She got into Central, and this isn't funny, because...
You can't do
no,
it.
You can't do it. I can't do it. I can... Look, if I cut the bit out where I laughed.
No.
The reason this girl got into Central School of Drama was because speech and drama, which I could not get into, though I auditioned twice and I think was pretty good, was because they took like 12 people, and the 12th person, two Americans, and one American died. I'm not smiling. And so she got in, unfortunately, and she got in.
She had an epileptic fit in a bathtub.
Right.
So don't want this.
No, don't upset this woman. Just she'll be a voice.
She'll
in the
be upset ride. Anyway, though. She has an upset energetic that finally results in a pleasantness. My daughter watches TV and she sees people she knows. So now she expects everyone she knows to be on TV. They put an ad. So Meryl's on in the upcoming thing of what's the movie?
Schindler's List.
No,
House of the Spirit.
House of the Spirit.
Schindler's List. That's not funny.
Okay. So, no, but the next thing is, so they put an advert on for Schindler's List, and my daughter says, Hannah. That's funny. It was just a dark-haired woman running for a bad train. A train you wouldn't run for, say. You would run away from that train. Only she figured, Hannah!
But it's a compliment.
Just everyone that she knows is now on TV. But I just love that she was in Schindler's List, which means that she has an eye for the tribe. But she didn't say, like, grandpa or anything.
No, but you look like a kind of Schindler person.
I know, and
she
Billy
is a Schindler
at 21
person.
Months knew that.
But pull your hair back. Let's
and run for the train. Do the running for the train thing.
Did you call Liz Taylor, like, mom?
Oh, yeah, I still do. Yeah. She adores me, drags me up onto her lap. What happened today, darling? How is the book doing? She adores me. No. No, I met her once when I was about 3. I went to the Beverly Hills Hotel with my father, and what I remember was she was wearing like a see-through negligee when she answered the door. And I remember it, so I must have known it was very important, and this was the clue to what had happened that had gone wrong.
And did your mother, was she kind of, what was she then? Was she as angry?
She's not angry. I'm on her behalf. But my mother was never upset. She was always like a fan of Elizabeth Taylor.
She thought, well, if you're going to be left for somebody.
Might as well be Elizabeth Taylor. And that is really probably the truth.
That's her ego wasn't damaged, I'm sure.
Oh, it was. It was. Because Elizabeth was a friend, and it was a very public humiliation, and she wanted to die. And she had two small infants, and you cannot have the luxury of being depressed. I know this now, too.
Well, you got Paul Simon, which...
And I wrote all those lyrics. God, we're... You know.
You wrote Bridge Over River Kwai?
Bridge Over Bridge Over Debbie's Daughter, I think it was. But he changed it. I said, you're a fool. It's really catchy. Like a... But he changed it.
What does he know?
Men.
I know.
Go figure.
But he must have been fun. He doesn't
he
look
is fun,
fun. But he looks
oh,
like maybe
well,
when the
I
doors
mean,
are shut.
It's not like a consistent... But no men are.
And did you laugh at his jokes in the beginning?
That's how I got him.
Really?
I bet. Screamed with laughter.
I bet. And then
stupid.
When did like the stretch
no,
marks
no,
in your
no,
face?
No, no, no. So when he makes fun of being incredibly serious,
yeah.
It is funny, funny, funny. And the funniest person drunk in the world, period.
Really?
Pouring wine on animals. You know, that's funny to me.
Yeah, but you know, I've been with men where you think it's impossible to get this guy to laugh, and suddenly when, you know, there's something
oh, that's
to
the
life.
Big thrill. But
yes.
I mean, Harrison is the Harrison more extreme Ford. Version of that, where you think, he's never going to smile. He is never, literally, there's going to be, his teeth are going to hyperventilate. I can't believe it. And then it happens, and it's like a miracle. It's like the virgin birth of his teeth. And you get so excited that you accomplished making him laugh. So, yes. There you
but
go.
Then a lot of times with when you get yourself in those situations, you're the kind of like tap dancer, you know what I mean? And that is your mission.
I was the one
and then
that
you
was
hate
practicing
yourself.
Wise, knowing looks in the stone grass of their periphery. You know what I mean? They would be like, and I would be looking like I was deliberately not caring that we weren't talking at all. I was like the dead air queen, you know, like captive by dead air. Contained by it. It's too quiet. I'm supposed to be making a point. But none existed. I acted like somebody like, how could you leave me? I'm so much fun. And like, who wants to have fun all the time, though?
I've been the tap dancer
they
all
do
my
say
life.
I want you forever, and then they go, oh, but I mean, forever just ended. You know, I want, now I'm, oh, I should have had a V8. Now I want something calmer. I want to be the center. I don't want to be Carrie Fisher's boyfriend.
Right,
I don't
okay.
want to be Ruby Wax's sidekick.
Shut up, my husband's listening to this.
Well, but I mean, if you achieve a certain celebrity, you want to date an accomplished woman, you might not want to marry one. Because you don't want to be Miss, you know.
But between you
my
and
my mother's
Simon,
husband.
I'd say there's not much
right.
competition. So what was the problem?
He's definitely Mr. Carrie Fisher. Yeah. What? does she want to be on the show?
No, I don't want to stop your private life.
God forbid.
Hello? Is this a Melissa that I didn't know?
Yeah, you know Melissa. We
I do. I got the wrong person.
No, you this, like her.
I know. I like her.
You
like
you her. On, say hi really, really yeah. loud.
I thought it was nice.
There, you're on a show.
She has a friend.
I have a friend
in England
who likes
gives
her.
Me a party, and she says she likes
she has
me.
A party, and I didn't get invited.
You are invited. She
Melissa?
Wanted me to invite you.
Hi, it's Ruby.
It just happened. Look!
You.
We're
look
filming
at this room.
This
I'd love to come over later.
Oh, good.
Do
you know who I am? You know who Eddie Fisher is? Who's Eddie Fisher?
Ordering and doesn't what in the film?
I don't know.
See, he doesn't know who I am, but he knows I was
right,
in a film.
I'll see you tonight. Bye-bye. I'm invited to a party.
See, that's what's good about interviewing me.
What were we talking about? Oh, men.
Oh, what a shock.
What a shock.
No, we were... Oh, this is for your child, not for you.
Is it really?
Yeah.
I love these.
Isn't it a... It's my present to your child.
I'm
I know
so
she's
happy.
Too young to appreciate
no,
it.
She isn't. She's seen one in the store,
but
sort
she,
of.
It's never too young to think things with batteries can make you happier than individuals.
Not.
I couldn't agree with you more. It's the early learning training. Look at you. See, that's the first time I've seen you smile today.
Would
much,
you want
right?
him? I'm not
can't
relaxing.
Believe it's your social life again. Hello? Miss Fisher's room. Not really, she's in a cheaper room, but she'd like to pretend this is her room. And there's another one that's in the book, the beginning of Delusions of Grandma, that's really good. It was something about your girlfriend said, or somebody said.
We were going to all these like self-help, hilarity, est, blah, blah. And we were at the est 6 day, which is this incredibly intense, hello. And they do a sex night there, which is like, you want to shoot yourself. If you have to stand up in all these categories, like if you've ever thought of having sex with your, There was one girl that stood up
with
in
your
zero.
What? You tell me
your mother, your father, oh, your right. brother, your friend, your blah.
So
your
you have
pet.
To stand up?
You have to stand up and sort of, if you ever have done these things, if you've ever done, put your hand inside a donkey and wave to his nose, you know. So it was everything that you could possibly think of, right?
You have to raise your hand.
Didn't stand up for anything. played with yourself. I mean, I started to feel guilty and stood up in categories that I didn't belong in. Because there were people standing up for things you couldn't believe.
You watched this at an ESC meeting?
So we watched this. It goes on and on and on. Here's what they did. If you got too tired, you had to stand at the side of the room holding a log, which would drop on your head if you fell asleep. I got up on the stage and they said to me, so what's your deal? What's your problem or whatever? And I went all around it, and it was drugs. I was like 24 then.
Right.
And I'm standing in front of 100 people. And so finally they said, what is your problem? And they show me the sheet where I put down, I would like to stop taking painkillers for no reason.
Right.
And I went, oh! I got off the stage and I felt like my skin had been removed. And they said,
well, you know, part of it is standing in front of 100 people because it's like the...
It is.
That's
the
why
process
you write too.
Of saying, I'm an alcoholic.
The process of writing
immediately,
it, too.
Yes.
The
yes.
poison leaves you.
Yes.
It's over.
As soon as I've written this book, it's no longer true
right.
of me.
I can
so
imagine.
It always makes me laugh when people say, are they autobiographical? Not anymore.
Right. Somebody else.
But they were at the time.
That girl on the cover.
If I'm able to say it and name it, it is no longer so, precisely. If I can observe it, I no longer have to be it. I'm
but that's
free
brilliant.
To be something else also. I didn't know it. It's the power of journaling.
Yeah.
But the danger is that when you're writing it, it slimes you. Like you say,
yeah.
the pages are sticky and your life becomes what, then you become this character.
Yes.
So I get stolen for the period of time that I'm writing the book, and I don't write that fast.
Right.
The first one, yes. The next one's no. And as I see, I was writing the second book, and I was with Paul.
Right.
And I said to him at one point, these people can't end up together.
Ooh, and so the book starts to have a life
make
just
it,
as strong
it
as yours.
Sucks.
What can a man possibly give you? I mean, it's, and I'm not saying
peace
you.
Peace of mind.
You think that's
not
the,
peace
because
of
the
mind.
Rest of the world.
My mind is not his province.
Mm.
Peace of life. Do you know what I mean?
You just want to be.
I want to be allowed to be who I am without it getting up your goddamn nose. His. And you are permitted. And who might even permit you? Be who you please.
Right.
I want a very affectionate roommate. I don't want to be possessed. I don't want to be judged, criticized. I don't want to be as flawed as I've been with them. I don't want to be found.
Well, why can't you marry your best friend?
Hannah, will you marry me?
I know, darling.
Seriously.
We've been trying,
well, I don't mean with a woman, okay? You know,
I'd like to.
Mary, you have men friends.
My mother was in a movie called Susan Slept Here, and in it, it's with William Powell, Dick Powell, and he, I wish it was William Powell, and he, at one point, she goes to kiss him, and she goes, and he kisses her on the forehead, and it was my first sense of humiliation.
Oh.
I looked over my shoulder to see if anyone else had seen that my mother had just been, in effect, rejected because she
that's
was
a great
stupid
image.
Little ingenue, and I must have been 3 or 4.
And that stuck
What's
with you.
What's the Eddie story?
Well, the Eddie story is the only other person I've ever told this to, and I swear to God, is my therapist. Because it's my,
wow.
you know, seriously, it's not what he did. This is your father,
it's
Eddie Fisher.
Do.
It's what he didn't do.
I knew it!
No, wait, listen.
Story of his life.
I'm in Vegas. My father took me there when I was about 6, and I was a really ugly child. I had, like, bad teeth, you know, those, like, kind of the missing link thing. And and I had my Shirley Temple doll with me. So we're at the Dunes Hotel, and my father says, there's Eddie Fisher. And he was sitting with some cronies of his. And my father went over to Eddie Fisher
oh,
and said,
no.
Hey, have I got a girl for you? Hey, Ruby, come on out here. Come on out here. And I was hiding behind the thing. And he went, she's beautiful. And your dad started to go, yeah, let's see her. And my father, I think it might have been 10 seconds, but to me it was like 8 years went by going, boy, she's a knockout. He was with Liz
How
Taylor
old
at the
were
time.
You, 6?
Maybe 8. He's a knockout. You got to see
cruel.
This chick. Come on out here, Ruby. And I wouldn't come out. And my mother went behind me and went, go on out there, Ruby. And I went out. And Eddie Fisher and his friends went, ha, 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 ha.
Oh, my oh God.
it wasn't cruel of your father. You know what I mean? It wasn't
you
like,
know what? It was cruel of all the
it
adults.
It was cruel of my
no,
dad.
It was cruel of every
everybody.
Adult in
Isn't
that
Isn't that
room.
Horrible?
All right, we're going shopping now.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
I don't want to get into this on your shirt.
I don't know why.
I knew it.